warring nation. Perhaps this is why they have gathered such an army of amazing, passionate fans. At their heart is a frontman and songwriter who takes his place as one of the most iconic rock stars of all time. But more than that, he is never disappointed, never sold out, and remains utterly real. I can promise you, from the times that I've met him, that the hair and the lipstick is always there. It's him. More than all of this, they are a band who have written songs of such breathtaking simplicity and beauty that genius really is the only word for it. In 1992, we said they were the most successful alternative band that ever shuffled disconsolately across the earth. They are strange as angels, and we love them very much. And it is a huge honour to have them here tonight. But before we go any further, let's have a few words from the amazing Tim Burton.
I just want to say that a long time ago, when I was an animator at Disney, chained to a desk having to draw cute talking animals, I was fucking depressed. And this music was the only thing that really saved me. Spoke to anyone who felt strange and weird, and I just want to thank them for inspiring me and so many other people for so long, and they truly deserve this. And let's take a look at something. Are we here for the trees?
Strong image, and something you can really identify with if you're doing it. having no way of being able to express your feminine side, shall we say. Remember when I was like 40 minutes hanging out with these two girls, just the back comb on and stuff, her lips.
Yeah! Spider-Man calls, something through the shadows of the evening sun. Steal their past the windows of the glistening dead, looking for the victim, shivering in bed. Searching out fear in the gathering gloom, and suddenly a movement in the corner of the room. And there's nothing I can do, I realize the fright. The Spider-Man is having me for dinner tonight. Thank you. always seem to fade when I play this on Friday. We'll be right back.
to do.